Hello everyone, this is Commander Curses, and I have just installed the beta 3.9 update. There's some changes, and I want to show you my first look. This is the first time booting up the game since I loaded it. This all seems pretty standard, but I'll just give you a look at what I see. Would I like hardware detection? Yes. My settings have been high quality. Check it out! That is an Oscillus starport. Wow. That looks pretty cool. Much better than the plain black screen. They're really kicking it up a gear for the premiere event in a couple of days. And this new intro screen looks really cool. Alright, I'm going to get straight to the action. Open play. Sadly, they removed the option for offline mode. There's been much wailing and gnashing of teeth on the forums, but it's sad for people that won't be able to play because it's offline, but they always said it was going to be an online game, so sorry for all the people that can't play, but I really like online games, and I'm really keen on keeping on playing this game. Alright, while we wait, I may do a quick cut, because who knows how long it's going to take. Here we go. So what they've done, they've had a full reset. I'm back in the crusty sidewinder. Let's have a look. Wow. Well, it's a lot brighter than before. Maybe just because I'm inside the station. But yeah, pretty grubby. All right. Enough whinging about that. Where's all my buttons? Trade rank, penniless, explorer rank, aimless. Wow. So they've added some things. Reputations for the major factions, Federation, Empire and Alliance, and they have changed the way that you can get your elite status, so you can get it by trading, exploring or combat instead of just by combat like the old games. So this is a bit different. I've only got 1000 credits. They've added the rebuy cost, which is an essential change in my opinion, because the rebuy cost tells you how much you have to pay if your ship gets destroyed. And so if you do not have enough money, you will lose your ship, and it would be a good idea to save money. Okay, what else have we got over here? They've changed the icon of the orbitals and the cities to be different, so the orbitals look like a little TV antenna, and the cities look like truncated cubes. Cities. The large space stations, that's what I mean. And we're in the old Eranin system. And I've got my little 7.5 light year jump spaceship. Alright, what does the starport services look like? Pretty similar. Look at the bulletin board. So the mission icons are a bit different. Since beta 3 you've been able to see available and unavailable missions just based on the amount of cargo space you have, basically, is what sorts that out. But they've also added missions based on reputation, which only show up once you're a certain reputation with the factions. What's this? Light cargo for 1500, alright. What else have we got? Azaban, so I could take 1,000 or 1,500. Might pass on that for now. The contact screen, nothing new. Repair screen, nothing new. There's no trade at the station. I'll have to show you that shortly. And let's look at outfitting. Ooh, shiny. Where's my mouse pointer? Here we go. Okay. So we can go swap. So I can swap my lasers from different sides. That's very cool. Now they'll do a little swap. Swappy swap. That's pretty cool. You can see the rating, the class. Doesn't really have much info like it used to. It's just kind of the rating and the class. And let's see, buy and equip. Oh, here's all the things. So, yeah, I can compare it with my missile rack. And my current stuff is here. It's a thermic versus explosive and all of that. So it's got a health bar now. Anything new? That's all I can notice for now. There's a lot more stats on the missile than on the laser. I've also noticed over this side, on the right, there is power usage retracted and deployed, so you can see whether or not you're going to need to turn off some of the systems when your guns are on. So that's kind of interesting. Let's see what else they have. Utility mount. They have kill warrant scanner. I'm so poor I can't afford anything, but it does tell you how your jump range will change by equipping heavier things. That's a very good change, because it's really annoying when you install your new, I don't know, frame shift drive or whatever you're buying, and you end up with a jump range, because of the weight, lower than you can actually get out of the system. Maybe not frame shift drive, but something else. And so actually being able to see how far you go when you're comparing or deciding to buy something is actually a really cool change. All right, universal cartographics. I think that there is a new change with that. You can buy data on the other systems like you could before, but there is a change that you can buy trade data from systems for 24 hours to know the price of the system you may be going to, which is a very good change again, due to the fact that it's quite difficult to do trading without an external tool or a piece of paper and a pen, which seems a little redundant in a 1200 years in the future space simulation. Okay, just quickly look through the systems and then I'll fly off to the next system to check out the trading. These all seem pretty similar as before. Yeah, I'm still pretty happy about the all the new things. All right, I'm going to go to, where should I go to? I'm going to go to Asban City. See what we can see. Oh, this part. All right, I'm going to do this part, and I will catch you all on the outside of the station. Well, that was fun. They reset all my controls, so I had to spend a little while with my control pad figuring out what the new controls were. All right, now what does this place look like? Oh, I can't see. Let's look around. It's all so much brighter and more vivid. I like that. And this looks like a different type of station, which I haven't seen before. Well, station. Starport. What's this look like? It's pretty cool. It's pretty, pretty cool. Alright. How do I change my settings? Put my engines up to max. Yeah, my controls are really weird. And not because backwards is forwards, because it's not. I'm just flying backwards on purpose. But oh, my roll is on the wrong stick. Oh, and look, Azaban City is behind the planet. But wait, I have a button which jumps me into... How do I boost? I can't remember how to boost. Caps lock? No. No, landing gear. What's the landing gear button? Alright, I'm going to try and jump into hyperspace, and I will catch you there. Okay, I've got all my axes set up, and we're just about at Azaban City. So I am going to drop out and try a landing. There we go. Hopefully all my controls are set up. Wow, look at that nebula straight in front of me. Wow, that was cool, dropping out of Super Cruise. You see the station pop in front of you. You're a little bit further out than you used to be, I think. Oh, what's going on? A little bit of lag. Is my targeting working? It is. Can I request docking? I can. Okay, so let's go land. Alright, I might slow down a bit. good old Azaban City looking as dark and foreboding as ever. Oh man, I slowed down too much. I'm not in my Viper anymore. It feels so slow. Who's that? Commander Temugin. G'day, Commander. Landing gear. Pad 29. There we go. It's over behind Pad 28. There we go, slowing down even more. I might speed up just a tad. Alright, how good am I? How good am I? Not very good. Alright. Here we go. Oh, wow! That's a very special landing technique I perfected myself. There we go. Alright, enter hangar, starport services. The reason you click enter hangar first is because it takes a little while for you to go down to the outfitting bay, and while you're doing that, you can check out the bulletin board. So what have we got here? Cargo, delivery, all of that good stuff, but not anything really that I can't get later. Ooh, Eranin needs covert help. What's this? I need non... Oh, it's just a delivery quest. And you get nothing. You get donate 0 credits. Oh, I guess it's just for rep. Alright, well, whatever. We've got the commodities market. So what have we got here? Oh, it looks very similar to before. So we've got Iran and... What's that? What is it? Why is it... There's one of them. It's a rare commodity. 9,000 credits to sell, but 1,000 credits to buy. I can't quite afford it. That's cool. So you've got rare items at some places. There's only one of them at the supply. So that's a one way you get to get rich quick, I suppose. See if keep your eye out for really good priced rare commodities. Okay, so I can't... Ooh! Exported to, that's pretty cool. So you can see where you can export it to. So if I bought 4 beers, I could take them to these places and everyone would be happy. Well, 4 people would be happy because I only bought 4, not even a whole 6-pack. All right, but that's really neat. It tells you where you can take things. It doesn't tell you how much they give you for them, but presumably those places will give you a slight profit and maybe some will be better than others. What about universal cartographics? Anything in here right now? Nah. Okay. Cool. And the shipyard, what does this look like? There's one ship. Okay. And it looks exactly the same. Alright. Well, outfitting. What have we got? So, there's a multi-cannon. So if I go compare, it's got ammo and things. Yep, just the same as before. And yeah, it shows you get a increase in the amount of power that you're using, or increase, a decrease in the amount of power that you're using when they're deployed, because the cannons have a lower power draw. Yep, another kill warrant scanner. Alright, cool. Alright, I'm going to take a break now and I will come back to you with another video on what I get up to in the next day before the premiere of Elite. So thank you for joining me and I really appreciate you watching. I will catch you in the next episode. If you liked what you saw, leave a like and subscribe if you want to see more. I will catch you in space. Safe flying.